One day, Mr. Gruber took Paddington on an outing to the law courts. "I think you'll find it interesting, Mr. Brown," he said. "It's a bit like watching a television play. Wait here, and I'll see if I can find you a good case to watch." Paddington thanked Mr. Gruber, and then settled down to a quick sip of some of Mrs. Bird's steaming hot cocoa. To his surprise, he'd hardly begun when he heard his name being called. "Calling Mr. Brown! Calling Mr. Brown! Here, is your name Brown? 'Cause if it is, they're waiting for you." "Mr. Gruber must have been quick," exclaimed Paddington. "I don't know about Mr. Gruber. It's old Justice Eagle trying the case today, and he don't like to be kept waiting. You best get a move on." "I'm sorry, Mr. Eagle," called Paddington. "I'm afraid my eyes got steamed up."
"Your eyes got steamed up? Upon my soul, in all my years as a judge, I've never heard of that as an excuse before."
"It's not an excuse, Mr. Eagle. It's the cocoa."
"Do you swear?"
Paddington gave the man a hard stare. "Never. My Aunt Lucy taught me not to."
"Silence in court." "I see no mention of an Aunt Lucy, Mr. Cloudsworthy. Do I take it the prosecution are not going to call her? To tell you the truth,
I don't think she would hear you if you did call her, Mr. Eagle. She's in Peru."
"Aunt Lucy's in Peru? I find this very hard to accept."
"With respect, my lad, I don't think she's important." "Aunt Lucy's not important?" exclaimed Paddington. "She brought me up."
"Quite so, but we have a very big case here."
"I've got a small one. It's got a secret compartment where I keep all my important papers."
"Really? I thought perhaps it was where you kept your briefs."
"My briefs? But I'm only here for the day."
"Silence! This is no laughing matter. Briefs are papers lawyers bring with them when they attend court."
"Oh, I don't have any of those, Mr. Eagle," said Paddington, "but I've got some marmalade sandwiches."
"Is this really part of the evidence you're submitting, Mr. Cloudsworthy? A bear's sandwich? We'd better mark it Exhibit A. I'll examine it more closely later."
"Mrs. Bird will be pleased," said Paddington. "I don't think she's ever had any of her marmalade exhibited before, especially in court."
"In that case, we'd better call her. Perhaps she can throw some light on this unfortunate affair." "Call Mrs. Bird! Call Mrs. Bird!"
"I don't think she's here either. I expect she's out shopping with Mrs. Brown."
"Mrs. Bird's out shopping? Really, this is intolerable. Is there no one here today?"
"You could try Mr. Gruber," said Paddington. "I know he's here. At least, he was."
"Call Mr. Gruber. Call Mr. Gruber. Good gracious."
"I'm afraid," said Mr. Gruber, "there has been a slight misunderstanding. As I'm sure your lordship realizes, there are a good many Browns in this world. I believe this is the one you really wanted to see."
Mr. Justice Eagle looked at Paddington and then at the exhibits in front of him.
"It's been a very trying morning," he said, "in more ways than one. I think perhaps it's time we stopped for elevenses."
Paddington was most impressed at the thought of a judge knowing about elevenses. "Perhaps, Mr. Eagle," he said, "you'd like some more exhibits. There are lots more where this one came from, and I don't suppose I shall be coming to court again for a long time."